Hey everyone, what's up? Matt here from SoundSwitch. In this video, we're going to show you how to use a Pioneer DJ setup with SoundSwitch's auto loop feature using MIDI clock. Let's get into it. Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be showing you how to take a MIDI clock signal from any hardware and connect it to SoundSwitch. In this particular example, we're going to be using CDJs with a DJM900. But this is also compatible with any device or software that can send out MIDI clock information. Some devices will send this over MIDI directly, so you'll need a MIDI to USB interface, but most mixers that have USB ports, such as the DJM900 or 2000, as well as Denon mixers, can also send MIDI clock from their USB ports. Check with the manufacturer of your particular mixer to see if it supports MIDI clock out. And if it does, you should be able to hook up SoundSwitch with the mixer. So, how does it work? Basically, the mixer on the fly will calculate the BPM of the audio that's coming through the mixer and will convert that into a BPM clock, which is like a time signal or a timestamp that is sent from the mixer out through USB and into the computer. So the first thing we need to do is make sure that we have the USB port connected and we have it also hooked up to the computer at the other end. You can also see on the display that there's a BPM being read, and obviously on the players there is also a BPM displayed. Now over in SoundSwitch, we're going to want to use performance mode, but before we jump in, we just want to switch over to the preferences. We want to then choose the MIDI sync in option, which you see here under our input. And then under the port, we want to look for the MIDI device we're going to be using. Again, in this example, it's the DJM900 Nexus 2. So we'll select that. Then we'll select done. So we'll jump into performance mode and we'll choose the venue that we're going to be using with our particular lighting setup, which is the Gig Bar Move. So I'm just going to jump over into the MIDI window now, because this is where we'll be controlling all of the lighting effects. I'm going to turn on a blue override because that's a color I prefer. And I'm going to jump over into the standalone screen. This screen allows you to tap in the BPM, turn Ableton Link on and off, adjust some sync parameters, as well as beat shift. So jump the auto loop that's playing forward or backwards a beat. This is because MIDI clock doesn't actually give us a full time signal. It just gives us a count of what the timing of the track is that's playing. So sometimes if you're operating this as a lighting operator from side of stage, you might need to jump the auto loop forward slightly or back a little bit as well. You'll also need to use the cue button to start the light show. For example, if I press play here on our player, the track will start playing and the audio will start coming through. The display on the mixer will start counting the time and the BPM will start being sent and calculated from the player. So the way it works with this particular setup is that the audio is sent from the player to the mixer and the mixer on the fly counts the beats and sets the BPM. The BPM is then sent via the MIDI clock to the computer. So now that the track's playing and the BPM is being read, as soon as I hit the cue button, the lights will start to play in time with the audio. So here we go. You can see in the top left-hand corner of the screen that the BPM is now matching within about a BPM. This is because MIDI clock isn't necessarily absolutely perfect in its timing, but you can see if I adjust the BPM from 126 BPM to 119 BPM, you'll see that the display on the screen of the player is reducing the BPM number and the screen on the mixer is matching as well. So if you look over in SoundSwitch, you can see that the BPM is also changing. So as I bring that back up and I start to speed the track up a little bit, you'll be able to see that the BPM is set again on the players and again catches up on the mixer and then is also set in SoundSwitch and the light show is also in sync. You can then use the cue button to start the auto loop again, or you can switch over to the auto loop screen and you can start to launch different auto loops. So depending on the type of music you have, depending on the type of auto loops you've set up, you should be able to sync those auto loops perfectly in time with what's happening coming from the player and mixer setup. If you switch over to performance mode, you can turn off the override and you can change the color, or you can turn a strobe on, or you can set everything to all white, and you can control all those effects while SoundSwitch handles the timing coming from the MIDI clock. So that's how you can use MIDI clock to sync with auto loops in SoundSwitch. If you have any questions or you need any help, please let us know in the comments below or send an email to support@soundswitch.com. Thanks, and we'll see you in another video.